Very interesting new information overnight. If you own one of those new mini cars or you're thinking about possibly buying one, you may want to reconsider. Based on the latest crash tests, information just coming out overnight from the Insurance Institute of Highway Safety. Naomi Peskovitz joining us now with what this report is saying, and it's not good news.
Not good. Just, as you mentioned, just into our newsroom in the last couple hours here, I've been reading through all the details, looking up which cars the Institute says are safe, which ones aren't. Bottom line here, they tested 11 cars. None of them got the top rating.
I know we're going to see the video, and I don't think it's that surprising. I mean, these are tiny cars.
Ooh, it doesn't look good, right? Yeah. They do have a couple of recommendations, though, and we'll get to that in a second. Only one of the cars rated acceptable, and these are all new vehicles, 2013 and 2014 models. The group says mini cars are the worst performing they've ever tested. And let's look at the list. Just one car, there it is, the Chevy Spark, got an acceptable rating, but four ranked marginal and six ranked poor, including the best-selling mini car, the Nissan Versa. This doesn't mean all small cars are unsafe. Listen to what Insurance Institute's vice president recommends.
Small, lightweight vehicles have an inherent safety disadvantage in a crash. Moving up to a larger hybrid model can provide good fuel economy and offer a significant safety boost.
I know we're going to look at this video. Talk to us a little bit about how they did these tests.
Well, it's a new kind of test. They just started it in 2012, and there it is right there. It's like the crash test we've seen before, only it's from the corner of the vehicle, you can see, instead of just going straight on full from the front. Now, this is what that test looks like. Again, it's called the small overlap test. It mimics what happens when a car's front corner hits another car or something like a tree or utility pole. Now, that car right there, all of these, it slowed down, but it's driving 40 miles per hour when it hits. And you can see what happens. In many of the small cars tested, the frame just collapsed. That can make injuries much worse because the airbags, seats, and other parts of the car get knocked all over the place. So not good.
No, not good at all. All right, let's switch gears here now from the mini cars to potential new regulations for car seats.
Right. There's possibly a new proposal coming today from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. The new proposal would upgrade standards for car seats. So they're hoping this will save lives, protect kids from the side, which is these T-bone crashes, which is the worst for kids that are in car seats. They either get hurt or killed in these kinds of crashes. So.
Okay, so in 30 minutes from now, you're tracking another transportation story for us involving something that is close to us.
Close to everyone. Public transportation, the light rail's Green Line. We've all been anxiously awaiting its arrival, its opening day. Looks like it's almost done, right?
Looks like it's been done for a while. It goes right by our station here.
And the lights are already flashing. There are a few things they need to finish up, but then we're also going to find out later today what exactly the day will be when it finally opens. We'll have more on that coming up in about a half hour.
Sounds good, Naomi. Thanks. Megan.